Hello, everybody. 14th August 2017, a mudslide in Freetown, Sierra Leone killed 500 people. 200 of those people dead were children. 1st April 2017, a forest fire starts in British Columbia and rages on for months, destroying over 1 million acres of forest, making it the worst forest fire in the history of British Columbia. Summer of 2017, over 41 million people displaced from their homes in Assam and Bengal due to landslides and floods. These dates and places might not make any sense to you, nor probably the numbers that I just mentioned thereafter. Yet these are not just statistics. They are the number of innocent human lives that were sacrificed on the altar of economic prosperity and human apathy. Time has turned these thousands of human deaths into mere numbers, and I'm sure most of you would not have heard of these incidents, and if you did, would have forgotten about them by now. This apathy is the root cause of the repetitiveness of the horrific climate change-induced disasters that decimate humanity, pollute the environment, and throw out the prospect of a bleak future for our generation. Good morning, everyone. My name is Kehkashan. I am 17 years old, and as the founder president of Green Hope Foundation, I am truly glad to be here today to share our journey with you and also call upon you to take action right now. I am also the Youth Ambassador of World Future Council, a climate reality leader, the former Global Coordinator for the United Nations Environment Program, Nature Group for Children and Youth, and the United Nations Human Rights Champion. Now, I am reaching out to you today with a message of critical importance. Our generation is the last one that has the opportunity to do something about environmental degradation right now. Ice caps are melting, sea levels are rising, our species extinction rates have increased hundredfold in the space of a few decades. We are running out of fresh water, and our forests are turning into deserts. We are also faced with a new term, climate refugees. Over 50 million people are displaced from their homes every year due to floods, droughts, and climate change-induced disasters. And these millions of people now face a life of exploitation without any semblance of hope. So now the question to us youth is, what kind of future do we inherit? What kind of future can we, the youth, look forward to? Do we just remain mute spectators and allow our destiny to be defined by the short-sightedness of our policymakers whose only goal is short-term economic gain? Can we afford to continue putting carbon dioxide in our atmosphere despite knowing the ominous threat of global warming and still labeling it as a myth? The answer is obviously no, yet no one seems to care. This apathy must be rooted out, and that is why I founded Green Hope Foundation in 2012 on my return from Rio+20 to educate, engage, and empower young people to be a part of the sustainable development process. What started out as an initiative of a 12-year-old girl has now become a multi-regional organization with over 1,000 members in countries all across the world who work on fighting for climate justice, stopping land degradation, protecting our biodiversity, sustainable consumption, and fighting for gender equality. I firmly believe that the lack of awareness amongst civil society, or any society, is the greatest hurdle towards achieving a sustainable future. So to combat this, we conduct environmental academies, which are tailor-made conferences and workshops conducted by youth, for youth. And the success is tremendous because peer-to-peer communication is always the most effective. And through these academies, we've been able to create partnerships with government utility bodies and corporates. Now, the Sustainable Development Goals have one fundamental objective: to ensure to leave no one behind and to ensure a life of dignity for all. So Green Health places special emphasis on the marginalized sections of our society. We focus on rural communities, indigenous peoples, and refugee children. And through our Education for Sustainable Development campaigns, empower them to take actions to protect their immediate environment. Just last month, the Green Hope team and I traveled to the border of Lebanon and conducted several workshops with the hundreds of Syrian refugee children there. The response that we received was amazing. The children decided to conduct their own recycling campaign and gather their friends for a cleanup, and many of them even decided to plant trees. This just goes to show that engagement and empowerment are the two most important steps towards achieving a sustainable future. And that is the mission and vision at Green Hope Foundation. Do we face challenges? Yes, every day. From dismissive adults, to archaic rules that say no one under the age of 18 is allowed, to lack of funding. But we look at these challenges as opportunities. And we take inspiration from the words of Nelson Mandela, who said, "It always seems impossible until it is done." Thank you.